नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, sitting with us all over the world at this moment through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, Lotus News Channel, Janashri TV, Ishwar TV, and two-way video conferencing. And Siti is sitting with us through two-way video conferencing. Nityananda Nagara Bididi, Nityananda Nagaramu Hyderabad, Nityananda Nagaram Tiruvannamalai, San Jose Madurai, Los Angeles Arunachalam, San Dallas, Simi Valley California, Bangalore North, Seattle Chidambaram, Nityananda Nagaram Hyderabad, Paris Home Temple, Varanasi, Oklahoma Somanatham, Guadalupe Rameshwaram, Ohio Prayag, Toronto Kailasam, Singapore Singapuram, New Zealand Adi Arunachalam, Dubai Vaidyanatham, Port Washington New York, Hyderabad Guptakashi, San Diego Tiruvallavai, Dakota Dunes, Calgary Amarnath, Bogota, Colombia, Devon, UK, New York, Varanasi, Bangalore, Malleshwaram, Oman, Sivagangai, Jorpati, Nepal, Astoria, New York, Kathmandu, Nepal, Ozur, Dhyanapetam, Chicago, North, Colorado Springs, USA. I welcome all of you with my love and blessings. Today I'll continue to expand on the revelation I was giving yesterday, the experiential expression, infinite gods with infinite powers, with infinite intelligence, because each one of them are independently infinite intelligent. There is no need for any one controlling mechanism or guiding mechanism. Many of my disciples cannot tolerate that. Some of my sannyasis and ashramites, they were asking me yesterday, big debate. No. What do you mean? If you tell this, then no one need to do anything. They'll all tell they are God and they will not do any completion, they will not regulate themselves. They will not do any spiritual practice. They will do what they want. I said, let them do. What is the problem? I told the disciples who asked, I said, I think you have a deep incompletion about your failures and self-doubt. Out of that incompletion, you want me as a part of your life. Please understand. Out of any incompletion, you want me as part of your life, you will not have me in a right way. I should be only guru enlightening you. Not as a CEO, boss, or timekeeper, monitoring your activities, or peeping Tom, and the last one. No. I don't want to be any of that. Because you have incompletions with your self-doubt, you expect me to fill all those gaps. You want me to play all those roles. That is why you think I should play this role for everyone. No. It's very important for you to know I should play only the role of guru, enlightening you. That's it. That's it. And I say that's it, I mean that's it. Not any other role, like a boss, CEO, organization head. No, I should not be playing any of that role in your life. Please understand. When you think you are God and infinitely intelligent, automatically you will live in the space of completion. Integrity will be your breathe, your breath. Authenticity will be your hand movements. Responsibility will be your stomach movements. Enriching will be your life. You don't need separate teachings. You will understand you are God, you are complete, you are independent intelligence only when you are complete. You can't use the God mask to cover up something on your face. Godliness cannot be used as mask, it comes as a tejas from inside. It cannot be used as a mask to cover something on your face, but it comes as a brightness from inside. I tell you, all these mundane questions, I think, not only these questions look mundane for me, even for many of you, this question will look mundane, especially after going through this level 4 processes. I tell you guys, this IA level 4 is the best program I ever conducted. Even if the program ends today, I'll feel job satisfied. It is not going to end, don't worry. Even if it ends today, I'll feel I've done my job. Of course, we have more work. This is the best program I ever conducted. Blessed are those, especially you have done level 1, level 2, level 3 and came here. Because you guys can catch the whole thing without missing. More blessed are those who have done 2 IAs and came. Because it is like a very strong foundation. Even if you have come straight, it is okay. If you catch it, that's enough. If you catch the spirit of the whole program, that is enough. Because many of the unsaid things, you should catch if you are first timer. What a experience. So today I wanted to expand with some more addition of that experiential expression, Nityanandam. The practical implications of that principles, that experiential expression, the word principle, philosophy, none of these words will suit can be equivalent to experiential expression. I'll use the word, Sanskrit word, tattva. Experiential expression. Tattva. The truth, you. Truth told to you. Tattva is tattva. Experiential expression. The equivalent word in Sanskrit is tattva. I have no equivalent words in English. So this tattva, the nityanandam, the tattva, I'll expand the some more detail and the practical implications of this tattva. The practical implications of this tattva is called tattva jnana. First implication. All of us are God. Second, not equally powerful, but infinitely powerful. Please understand, infinite gods, each of them infinitely powerful. How much power to express and radiate is up to us. Infinitely powerful and please listen. Infinitely powerful and infinitely intelligent. Please listen. This word I am adding today. I have not added that word yesterday. Today I am adding. Infinitely intelligent. Because we are infinitely independent, intelligent, we don't need one boss. Supreme Godhead. Whatever you name, it is not required. We can just live trusting our intelligence. Our intelligence is enough unto itself. The constant self-doubt and self-denial makes you feel the need of the superior force in your life. Correcting force, guiding force, which is not required actually. Only this tattva, experiential expression, satisfactorily answers all the philosophical questions, doubts by various groups, various philosophies, various Puranas. So understand, because Shivapurana says all gods and goddesses can't even find the head or feet of Mahadeva. Brahma and Vishnu can't even find the head or feet of Mahadeva. Vishnu Purana goes to the extreme of saying even Shiva is established only on Vishnu. Vishnu is the base. And Puri Jagannath temple, even now Shiva stands as a guardian. If you have been to Puri Jagannath temple, you will see Shiva and Brahma both are standing as guardians outside the temple. And if you go to all Shiva temples, they put Vishnu behind Shiva with folded hands at his feet. That I am not able to find your feet. Brahma with folded hands saying, I am not able to find your head. That is actually the story of Arunachala. Brahma and Vishnu are not able to find the head or feet of the Mahadeva. And come on, then comes Devi Puranam, which says, all dasavataras came out of just nail polish of Devi. Not even nail, nail polish. Then comes ISKCON. They declare, even Narayana is demigod, only Krishna is God. That was really shocking even for me. I received enough shocks, but this was little. They go to the extreme of saying, even Narayana is demigod, because he has four hands. Only Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Of course, each one's faith, we are nobody to question. That's the beauty of Hinduism. Then comes Swaminarayan Sampradaya. They declare Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, all of them come for every yuga and go. Swaminarayan only creates all of them and sends. For each yuga, one Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra comes. It is Bhagavan Swaminarayan who creates every one of them and sends. Now I know what all my disciples are going to do. But I tell you, no sampradaya is false. All sampradayas are true. Because each God is infinitely powerful, infinitely intelligent. If you think Mahadeva is ultimate, that is the truth for you, you will experience that. If you think Krishna is the ultimate, that is the truth for you, you will experience that. If you think Bhagavan Swaminarayan is the ultimate, Aksharadham is the ultimate, you will experience that as the truth. You will experience that. If you think Nityananda is ultimate, that is the truth for you. You will experience that. No need for fighting at all. No need for fighting. So understand, the practical implications of this great truth. Infinite gods with infinite powers, infinitely intelligent. I again and again feel, more than talking, this tattva can be only transmitted in Upanishad. Just mirroring of the neuron activity only can transmit this tattva in you. How much ever I talk, 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 you will have questions. Upanishad is the best way to transmit the tattva, experiential expression of this great tattva, Nityanandam, which solves the questions, queries of all the different religious philosophies and which is the only solution for all terrorism, religious terrorism. This tattva completely removes fanaticism and eradicates religious terrorism. Because it is based on the truth coexistence. All gods, infinitely powerful, infinitely intelligent. So the Varuna does not need to be controlled by Vayu. Vayu does not need to be controlled by Indra. Indra does not need to control Allah. Jesus does not need to control Krishna. Buddha does not need to control Jesus. Mahadeva does not need to declare his supremacy. You don't need to fight with everyone. Nityananda is the ultimate incarnation. So no need for any fight. You only need to express your power and intelligence more and more. That's all. Not by declaring supremacy over others. Declaring supremacy over others comes only because you feel powerless, not because you feel powerful. When you feel powerful, you won't feel like declaring supremacy over others. When you are powerful, you will only feel compassion towards others. You won't feel like declaring supremacy over others. Declaring supremacy or the war is peak of foolishness. Bunch of fools gathering together and declaring supremacy over the other group is collective foolishness. No one need to declare supremacy over others. Infinite gods with infinite powers, with infinite intelligence. Now, let's sit for a few minutes in mirroring of the neuron activities of the ultimate consciousness, the master in Upanishad. Namah Shivaya. Thank you.
Nityananda Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/life